guys, it's me Olivia and I am back from my Disneyland Paris holiday. So, as you guys know, me and my little brother went to Disneyland Paris. We went from February the 19th till February the 23rd. It was such an amazing trip, like, it was so good. You'll have probably seen some of our vlogs because we had a couple of days where we filmed and we did a playlist of vlogs. So I'll leave a little link to this somewhere on this video. I'll leave it in the comment section down below as well, and like the little description, so you guys can check out the vlogs as well. So if you haven't guessed by the title and by my new mini years, this is gonna be a Disneyland Paris haul video. So I'm just gonna jump right in. I am gonna tell you guys a couple of prices where I can find the prices still on things. I haven't actually unpacked any of the things I've got yet because I've been waiting to film this video, so a lot of the prices will still be on there, and I'll try and get the prices for you guys so you have an idea of how much everything is, so you guys can plan for your trips too. Also, as a little side note, you probably realised that my background's like kind of different. It's because I am at my mum's house. I'm now living here. So this is my room at my mum's. It's got my lovely Disney canvases up here. So I've got my Cinderella and I've got my 101 Dalmatians canvas. And yeah, so I'm gonna be filming all my videos here from now on. I asked Archie if he wanted to be in this video. He's actually at school at the moment, so he's not gonna be in it. So I'm just gonna jump right in and start showing you guys stuff. Here's the first bag. So the first thing that I'm pulling out is, it's gonna sound so lame, right? So it's basically a giant poster that you colour in of Disneyland Paris. So I don't know if whether you guys will be able to see this very well, but it's like a poster of the parks, so like all the different lands, the castle, Frontierland, like Discoveryland, all the different lands. It has a couple of characters on there, like Jasmine and Aladdin and the dwarves and Donald and stuff like that. So I wanted to buy this to like colour it in and then frame it somewhere in my room. This looks like a giant poster on my wall in a frame. I have loads and loads of Disney stuff in my room, obviously. The canvases and things like that. I have like loads of little knickknacks. Like I've got little tsumtsums like in this corner down here. I've got some tsumtsums on my windowsill that I'm looking at right now. I also have an old fashioned picture of Mickey Mouse that my good friend Ellie bought for me. She bought that for Christmas. It's like a vintage print of Mickey Mouse. So I thought that I could do this and like colour it in. It seems like something kind of different. Like I just thought it seemed kind of cool. But yeah, I'm really excited to do it. This was $12.99 as well. So it's a pretty good price. It's apparently huge. Yeah, I'm gonna do this and frame it at some point in my bedroom. The next thing that I have is all wrapped up. I know what this is. So this is a little tray that I got. Basically, I bought this to put like my rings and jewelry on because I'm always losing my rings that I normally wear like every day. I take them off at night time and like when I go in the bath and shower and stuff, so I like leave them on the side. So I just thought this was like a cute little tray that I could put like at the side of my bed to put like my necklaces and jewelry on and stuff like that. And it was only $3.99. So that's pretty good. It's kind of like, I don't know how to compare it. Like this is my iPhone, the size. So it's like my iPhone 6S, so that's kind of the size of it. But yeah, I just thought it was super cute. I love the little design on it. I love all the little characters and all how the lands are represented. Also, repping Phantom Manor over here. But yeah, for $3.99, I didn't think I could go wrong. I just thought I'd pick it up. Oh my gosh, there's literally so much in this bag. Oh, I know what this is. So a lot of you guys will probably know that I'm quite a big fan of Alice in Wonderland. I saw this. It's like it's like a curly straw and it has the Cheshire Cat on it. He's looking pretty dapper on there. It's like a really big curly straw. I decided that I'd buy this because we normally have loads of plastic straws in the drawer at home. Because I wear a lot of lipsticks and it stains the cups, so I'd rather just have a straw to drink out so it doesn't smudge my lipstick, and I thought it was really cute. This was $4.99. Oh gosh. The next thing that I picked up is this mini pen. I got one the first time I ever went to Disneyland Paris, which was with my grandparents, and that ran out like only recently, so I decided that I would get this as well. I just thought it was super cute. You can't go wrong with like little mini stationery bits like this. So this was $5.99. Okay, the next thing that I picked up is something quite unusual. I've never bought anything like this or seen anything like this in any Disney parks before. So it's gonna seem so lame. Super grown up. adult things. It's a tea towel. Yes, it's a tea towel. So I thought it was super cute for one day when I move out and then I can have my own little tea towel. So the pattern of it is, it's all the alphabet, but it has a character with each letter that like the character's name begins with. So you can see for Q, it's the Queen of Hearts. V is Violet from The Incredibles. You've got Ursula for you, Zazu at the end for Z, and there's all sorts of different ones. I think it's great. Like, I just love it. There's so many different ones. Also, I thought it was pretty awesome because on the G, it's Genie! It's Genie, and he's one of my favourite characters ever, as some of you guys might know. You probably don't, but Robin Williams is like one of my biggest heroes, so the Genie is one of my all-time favourite characters. And this was $7.99. So the next thing is this little thumper teddy. I got this for my niece, Tilly, because I bought her, like, I really like getting her little gifts, and I thought that this would be super cute. It's really small and cute. It's from the baby section. We got it in a shop in Fantasyland. And it was actually Archie that saw it. And he was like, oh my god, look, it's a little thumper. And I was like, oh, I'm going to get a chili. So this was $12.99. The next things I am picking out are items of jewellery. So I've never actually really bought jewellery, like Disney jewellery, before, but I spotted it and then I thought, oh my gosh, that's like so understated but like really cool, like I could wear it with anything. And it's this little necklace of the castle. It's like a little silver necklace. I thought it was super cute. And then I got a little ring with the castle on it. I just thought they were two really cute things. Like, it's a real subtle way to wear Disney every day without it screaming Disney, because it's quite cute and you could wear it with anything really. They're on the green section, so they were $17.99 each. So they were pretty, I mean, I don't know, I think they're really good value for money because it's something that I'll probably wear every day, but yeah, they were $17.99 each. The last thing in the first bag is, oh my god, I know full well what this is this pasta. So, I don't know whether you guys know this or not, but the last time I went to Disneyland Paris, which was like January 2015, I think, I bought some princess pasta, and you get loads in here. So I decided I'd just buy some more. It's like a little tradition for Disneyland Paris that I've invented for myself. And this was €4.50. And before I forget, my ears I got at Disney as well. I think they were around like 21 or 22 euros. So they were really, really cute. They're super comfortable, super shiny. I love anything pink, as you guys might know. So I just thought I'd had to get these. I saw them and I was like, oh my god, I have to get them. It was my first purchase of the whole trip. I literally just walked in and I was like, I need those ears. We got them from like the Emporium or something. And then after that, we went to Casey's Corner. So, went to Casey's Corner, sporting off my beautiful pink sparkly ears. I absolutely love them. That's the first bag done. Now we're gonna go on to the second bag. So while I was in Disneyland Paris, I picked up 3 pins. So I got this first one, which was for the hotel that me and Archie stayed in. So this is the Hotel Cheyenne. It has like a little key at the bottom that dangles, like a little room key, which I thought was really cute. I think this was like €7.99 or something, because it's on the blue section. I vaguely remember it being like around 7 or 8 euros for this one. Then the second pin that I got was this one, which is the little medallion style thing from Pirates of the Caribbean. And I love the Pirates of the Caribbean. It is amazing. Archie got one as well, so we both got one of these pins. And this is on the green section, so this, I think it was like, It was less than 10 euros, that's all I know. And then the last pin that I got is this super awesome Phantom Manor pin, because obviously Phantom Manor is my favourite ride, guys. How do you guys not know this by now? Me and Archie both got this exact same pin, and it actually glows in the dark. We didn't realise until Archie had it on his lanyard, and we went into Phantom Manor, and at the beginning, in the stretching room where the lights go off, he was glowing. And I was like, oh my gosh, your pin's glowing. So that's how we know that glows in the dark. It's a pretty cool one. It was from the orange section. I don't know what price range that sort of is, but it was on the orange section. The next thing that I picked up was a pack of pens. I know that seemed really random, but I thought they were really cool and obviously they'll come in handy at some point. So they are this pack of pens. They have loads of different characters on them, and then each character has like a attraction that they're representing, sort of thing, I guess. So let me see. Goofy, the yellow one here, is representing Indiana Jones, and Goofy again in green is representing Phantom Manor. Minnie is a princess, so like the princess meet and greet hall. Stitch is dressed in like the bellhop, like attendance uniform for Hotel Tower of Terror. And Mickey is like red for the castle, and Donald is, I'm not sure what Donald is supposed to be. I think Donald's Space Mountain. So Donald's Space Mountain. So they've all got their own little attraction style thing. So this pack of six for $11.99. So this is something that we prepaid for. This is the Photo Pass Plus thing. So you receive it, we get like a voucher to collect it, and then it comes like with a little lanyard that you pick up. The lanyard's somewhere around my room, I can't find it. And then you get these little cards which you have to sign up and register to an account on an app. One thing I will say about the Photo Pass is, honestly, I personally do not think it is worth the money. Me and Archie were really disappointed because when I went to Florida, every single character you met had a Photo Pass person to take your picture, so it was a lot, like it was really, really worth your value for money to go. And there were people that were positioned just around the park just to take pictures of you, like with outside rides, outside like statues and things like that. But at Disneyland Paris, it was pretty weird because the only characters that you could get your picture taken with were Mickey Mouse, the princesses, which are in like this hall, and you have to wait, it's a really, really long wait time for princesses. It goes up to about 2-3 hours to meet one princess, Moana and Spider-Man. So you can only, it's not really worth the money, and you can get it on all the big rides. So the rides you can get on are Big Thunder Mountain, Space Mountain, Pirates of the Caribbean, Buzz Lightyear, Rock and Roller Coaster, and the Twilight Zone Tower of Terror. So the only ride we went on out of all of those was the Buzz Lightyear ride. So we were kind of disappointed. I mean, we probably should have read up on it a little bit more before, but my dad sort of booked it just thinking that it would be more pictures, which is what we all thought, but we didn't really get a lot. So we just had to take loads of pictures on our phones. And it's priced at €60. So it's kind of a lot of money when realistically you're only going to get like a couple of pictures. You're just better off taking your own camera or taking the phone and getting pictures off of there, because cast members are more than happy to take pictures on your device for you. So you're just better off getting things like that. Sorry, little rant over there. One of the last things I picked up actually is this little postcard. So it's Tinkerbell flying over the Jolly Roger and she's near Skull Rock. I basically had a notebook with this exact design on it the first time I went to Disneyland Paris, but I've lost it. And I loved the picture so much. So I saw this and I was like, whoa, I can't believe it. Like, this is insane. It's the same picture. And it was like €1.50. So I was like, I'll just get it so I can stick it up on a wall somewhere and it'll look really cute. I just thought it was really sweet. The next thing that I got is something that I've been eyeing up for a while because somebody at work, at my workplace, has one the exact same, and I thought it looked amazing and I had to have one. So it's this like thermos, and it is Walt Disney Studios staff. So it looks like pretty legit, like it's pretty cool. It's really, really heavy. You can put like hot drinks into it because I like to drink hot chocolate and tea, so I like to just take it. I figured it'd be really handy when I'm opening the shop in the morning at work. And this was only $12.99. like that's really good for like this quality style of thermos. So I was really, really impressed with it and I can't wait to use it. The last thing in this bag is something that I eyed up for quite a while before I went. A lot of people in like the Disneyland vlogging community have it. They have it as a jumper. similar to the Walt Disney World jumper that I showed you guys in my Walt Disney World haul from September. However, I looked for the jumper of this exact design and this shirt and I could not find it anywhere. Like, literally, it was impossible to find. I asked cast members, they didn't know what I was talking about. So I got it on a t-shirt instead. So it's Disneyland Paris and it has a really cute little sewn on designs on them. It's got like the cute little sewn on Mickey and then these little prints here. So it's for different rides. So there's Space Mountain and the castle, and then there's the Tower of Terror and the Walt Disney Studios logo. And on it, it says, "I only hope that we never lose sight of one thing, that it was all started by a mouse." So that's Walt Disney's quote. It's a really, really famous quote. But yeah, I thought it was really cool. I got it a little bit oversized, so it could be a bit baggy and I can wear it with like jeans. I thought it would be super cute. And it was €25.99. It's so cute. I love it so much. Moving on to the next bag now, guys. So the first thing that I have in here is a blanket. So it's a rolled up like fleece blanket and it's got Sorcerer Mickey on it. So I bought this because it was supposed to be $19.99, so it's supposed to be like €20. And then when you spend over a certain amount, I think it's like when you spend over €30 or something, you can get either this blanket or a beach towel in the same design for €10. So I got it for €10 and I thought it was super cute. I can just chuck it on my bed and get cozy with it when I want to. And it was super cute, so I'm really glad I picked that up. The next thing that I got are chocolates. Yes, I always have to buy a snack every time I go to Disneyland because they're addictive, they taste good, and I can eat them and reminisce about my times at Disneyland Paris. So these are all just like loads of little chocolates. And this bag was like $5.99, so you get quite a lot of them, it seems. You get quite a few. There's 72, I think, in here. Yeah, there's 72 chocolates in here. So that'll keep me going for quite a while. So this item that I picked up next is quite, I don't know, I don't want to say unusual, but it's something that I've never really seen in the Disney parks before. It is a colouring book, so it's quite heavy. It's like a hardback colouring book, quite big, and it has loads of different pictures, like, let me try and show you a really nice one. It's basically like different bits of art from Disney films. It's got loads of different characters in it. I just thought it'd be super cute to like draw and do like, so here's one. This is Mushu and Mulan and it's quite intricate as you can see. So I thought that was really cool. There's loads, there's princesses, there's the genie, there's Ratatouille characters, there's all sorts, there's Pinocchio, Alice in Wonderland, there's even Brother Bear characters in here. So there's literally all sorts of different characters. Oh, there's also, yes, they have all sorts of characters in here, literally there's all sorts. So I thought that was a pretty good buy. I really love to colour, like when I have nothing to do on my days off, I like to sit and colour. So this was €12.90. It's really, really heavy, sorry. But it's so cool, like there's loads of different pictures as well. So I'm gonna have a really, really fun time colouring all this in, I assure you. So the last thing that I bought is this. It's gonna seem so weird and grown up again. It's like one of those adult purchases. It is a washing bag, yay. It's so cute. It has like a little design with Minnie on it with all the laundry hanging out to dry. So it's like a washing bag. It was €14.99 and that's the little design that's on it. I'll show you there. So it's a part of the mini Parisienne collection where she's all like all fancy and fashionable and cute as Minnie is. So I thought it was super cute and it's just like a way to add Disney into my everyday life. So I thought it was kind of cool and I just had to have it. So the things that my brother got from Disneyland Paris, he got a couple of pins. Like I said, he got the Phantom Manor pin. He also got a Pirates of the Caribbean pin. He also got a pin lanyard, so it was like a Star Wars themed lanyard, which is pretty cool. I think it was only like €15 or something for that lanyard, which was pretty awesome. I thought that was pretty good. He also got I was so jealous because it was the last one. He got the grape soda pin from Up and I really wanted it, but he got it and it was the last one. I thought I'd let him have it because obviously he's never been to any Disney park before, so he got that because he was like, oh my gosh, it's amazing. So we got the grape soda pin. He also got a lightsaber. He got, I think he got Darth Vader because he was debating between Mace Windu and Darth Vader. Because yes, they have Mace Windu's lightsaber there. It's pretty cool. I think that's in the Emporium as well. It was like €20 and it's just like a super cool lightsaber. He also got a little plushie Mr. Oogie Boogie from Nightmare Before Christmas, and I do believe that was like $12.99. He also got a Nightmare Before Christmas t-shirt, so it was white with like all the characters on, and that was around €25 as well. He also bought a Nightmare Before Christmas wallet, so it was black with like Jack Skellington's face on them, so that was pretty cool as well. He bought that for himself because he doesn't actually have a wallet to put his money in, so he thought it was something practical that he could use as well, so I was kind of proud of him for getting that. Also, really quickly going to show you guys some things that I've picked over the past couple of days that I've like bought that are like Disney related. So it's two pairs of pajamas and a mug that I picked up from the Disney store. So I'll show you those now. The pajamas that I was talking about, they're like super silky and soft. They're kind of old now. They were in Primark. They're super soft. This is the little design that's on them. It's like vintage Mickey and Minnie design. They're like long pajamas as well, so I thought they were kind of cute. Obviously I didn't get these from Disneyland Paris, but I still had to show you guys because they're too cute not to mention. And they were £14, like great quality. Super cute for £14. What the heck? It's so good. The other pair of pajamas that I picked up from Primark that I'm going to show you real quickly as part of this Disneyland Paris haul are these Aladdin themed pajamas. So it's a tank style top, like a spaghetti strap top, and some shorts. So they're Aladdin themed, and you know I'm a sucker for anything genie. So it's this. It says, "Be careful what you wish for." I'm so excited to wear these. This is the top, and then the little shorts have loads of little lips on them. With these, the shorts and the tops, I always buy them a size bigger than what I am, because if you don't, when you wash them, if you put them in the tumble dryer, they tend to shrink and then they kind of get uncomfortable when you wear them. So I always buy them a size too big. So take my advice with that one. So these were like £6. So yet again, a bargain, especially as it's getting like a little bit hotter outside. It sometimes becomes a wee bit unbearable to be sleeping in long pajamas. So they're super cute and I just thought I'd had to show you guys. And the next thing that's not from Disneyland Paris that I'm just going to show you guys anyway is from the Disney store. So I got it in one of these little reusable bags. It's an animator's one, so it's like got all the little cute little characters on in the animator doll style like art. So this was £3.50 for the little bag. And then I've been waiting for this for so darn long. Oh my gosh, guys, you are gonna cry. I couldn't find any mugs, like hand mugs. I couldn't find any at Disneyland Paris that I liked. So I said to myself, I was like, I didn't find any in Disneyland Paris, so I'm gonna treat myself to one from the Disney store. Went to the Disney store, and lo and behold, poison apple mug. What the heck? It's so amazing. Oh my god, like seriously guys, I can't wait to use it. I don't know whether I'll use it or I'll put it on display. I can't decide yet. It's just so pretty and wonderful, like it's so good. This was $12.99. I just had to share it with you guys because it's awesome. I know it's not Disneyland Paris, but it's awesome. Anyway, there you have it guys. I know this haul is like considerably shorter than my Walt Disney World haul, but I didn't buy much at Disneyland Paris as I thought I was going to. There wasn't a lot there for this season. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. Give it a like if you enjoyed it. Make sure to share it with all your friends. Subscribe because it's free. And also comment down below and just let me know what your favorite thing was and whether you're wanting to go to Disneyland Paris anytime soon. I will see you guys for a brand new video next Sunday. I'll see you later. Bye.